When you look at Baker Mayfield, does the deal that Dak Prescott signed, that, you know, it's 4 years, $160 million, is that kind of a benchmark for Baker? Is that, if you're Baker Mayfield, is that what you're looking at and kind of measuring?
Well, generally, that's how it works, that the last few contracts are the ones that you use as your comps. But the last few contracts he will be looking at will be, as you mentioned, Dak Prescott, Deshaun Watson, and Patrick Mahomes. They're all up there in the, you know, Pat's in the $45 million range. Deshaun's in the 39. Dak is in the 40. So the numbers just keep going up and up and up. I don't think that they would give him that this offseason. But if he can show that he can take this team even a little deeper into the playoffs, maybe make the Pro Bowl next year, he might be able to get up there in that stratosphere.
When you look at what the Browns might be doing, do you think this is where they begin the talks about a new contract for Nick Chubb, for Baker Mayfield, for Denzel Ward? Is that based on the fact that that salary cap is going to jump pretty significantly moving forward?
Well, the first thing that will happen, and two super easy moves that they can and will make, will be to pick up the fifth-year options for Baker Mayfield and Denzel Ward. Those are no-brainers. They're going to do that. Whether they do it before the draft or after the draft, it will get done by that May 3rd deadline. Then they have a little time with those two guys to decide how they want to handle their extensions. Do they want to get them done before training camp begins? Or do they want to delay them and put them off until after this season? So those are just the decisions they can make on those guys. There are other players that you don't necessarily want to take your good old time with. And those would be guys like Nick Chubb, Wyatt Teller, guys that are going into the last year of their contracts. So they will have to start talking to all of those guys and see how they want to handle it. As you mentioned, the price tag for Nick Chubb keeps going up. When you look at Aaron Jones and what some of these other really good running backs are making, they're in the double-digit millions, and some of them are well into the double-digit millions. It's really not the analytics way to pay a running back like that. So I'm sure they would probably want to come up with some kind of a creative, maybe incentive-laden deal, sort of like what they did with Kareem Hunt. They want to keep Nick Chubb. I mean, there's just no question about that. I just don't know if they want to do the kind of deals, the traditional deals that we've been seeing lately.